What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel. This is part 6 of my interview magazines collection. This is the last video. In total, it was 18 magazines. The first magazine in this video has Lisa Bonet on the front. The date is April 1987, and it costs $2.50. Andy Warhol passed away 2 months before this magazine came out. And then here are Frank Zappa's kids. Lisa Bonet is an actress. She was 19 years old when this magazine came out, and she was married to Lenny Kravitz and Jason Momoa. Here are some magazines from the 50s and 60s. Jane Fonda is in the top right, and Ursula Andress on the right page. And then there's Debbie Harry on the right page from Blondie. There wasn't too much going on in this magazine. The next one has Cyndi Lauper on the front. The date is April 1986, and it costs $3. This one is a lot thicker than the other magazines you have seen. It has a total of 307 pages, and this one is all about music. Here is Val Young and the Beastie Boys, and then some groups from Japan. On the left is the newest album by the Rolling Stones, Dirty Work. And then some music groups from Berlin. During this time, it was still the USSR, so that's kind of interesting. Cyndi was 32 when this magazine came out. She has songs like Girls Just Want to Have Fun, Time After Time, and True Colors. And then it says some facts about her, and one of them says she got in trouble at the CBS building for signing in with security as Ella Fitzgerald. And then some jazz musicians, Miles Davis, David Murray, Dizzy Gillespie, Wayne Shorter, 12 of Brooklyn's Best, and Sonny Rollins. Ozzy Osbourne and Dee Snider. To the left is Gene Simmons and his mom. Here's Joan Jett and David Lee Roth. Elvis Costello. And the band Heart on the left page. Brian Wilson from the band The Beach Boys and Jackson Brown. Perfect ad for Cyndi because she would always dye her hair. Here we have the Temptations, the Supremes, and Nelson George. The Queen of Soul, Aretha Franklin. She was in my previous video, so be sure to check that out if you haven't yet. Luther Vandross and Kool & the Gang. I thought this was cool. It's John Lennon's 1972 concert, and it was now available on album or video. Now on to country music. We have Jimmy Buffett, Rodney Crowell, Marshall Chapman, and the Oak Ridge Boys. On the left page is Jim Morrison, Janis Joplin, Eric Clapton, Ginger Baker, Keith Richards, and Mick Jagger. And in rap, we have Curtis Blow, LL Cool J, The Fat Boys, Houdini, and UTFO. And I did have the Tom Cruise magazine. That was the first video. Here we have Don Henley and Glenn Frey. And then the last one you will see has Molly Ringwald on it. The date is August 1985 and it costs $2. This one was a lot thinner. It only had 143 pages. There wasn't too much going on in this magazine, in my opinion. Molly was 18 years old at the time. I do like the pictures that they took of her, especially this one right here. I like how they did her hair. She starred in The Breakfast Club, 16 Candles, and Pretty in Pink. Those movies came out one year after the other, so that really helped her become popular. And here's John Hughes, and he wrote all those movies. Like I said, there wasn't too much going on in this magazine, and not that much fashion either. After this, you're going to see the whole collection. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed seeing my Interview magazine's collection. And of course, until next time.